So now let us see how we can work with the filter options inside of Pixlr X. To access the filter option, you can go on to the left side right here where it says filter. The shortcut for it is F. So let me just click on it, and over here you can see that there's a series of sliders that you can work with. So over here, this is the picture that we're going to work with for this lesson. So over here you can see that there's a certain level of sharpness, and the top level right over here, the top option right here, is sharpness. So if I were to click and drag this around, you can see that the sharpness of the picture rises, but do note that the noise is seen right over here as well. So if you were to decrease the sharpness, you can see that noise is not there, but if you were to increase the sharpness, you can see that the noise is there as well. So if your picture is blurry and then you want to make it a bit sharp, then you can actually go over here. You don't go all the way in, but just a bit enough so that the picture seems sharp. So you can do something like this to make the picture more clear. The clarity over here adds into the sharpness. So you can go over here and see that you get all of these details right over here. So if you were to decrease the clarity, you can see that it smoothens out the pattern right over here, just like that. But if you were to, you can see that everything is soft right here when I bring down the clarity. But as I bring up the clarity, what happens is that the patterns get more distinct right over here. So depending on what you want, whether you want a very smoothened out look or you want a very sharp look, you can increase out the clarity as well, just like this. The other option you have is smooth. So if you were to increase this, you can see that it smoothens out everything. This is great to remove out any noise that is there. So you can increase the sharpness right here and then smoothen out the picture a bit to actually remove everything out and make the picture look clear, as you can see. So it really removes out these noises, as you can see right here. So if I were to smoothen it out, you can see that the noises becomes much more softer and the picture is better to look at. So that's what I want to use smoothen out for. That's the blur option. So if you want to blur out the picture so that you want to have text in front or so forth, then you can blur out, as you can see right over here. And as with the adjust option, you can go over here and type in the value directly as well. So this is 50, so that the smoothen option right over here works out just like that. So I'm just going to go around here. I don't want to work around with blur. The other option you have is green. So you want to make your picture look old, you want to have some noises in there, you can add in greens just like that, as you can see right over here. So now if I were to decrease this out, it's smooth. So you want to make it look a bit vintage, you want to make it look like a natural picture, you can add in some green as well. I'm not going to add in any on mine. The other option, so this is the detail option right here. That means it works with the details of the pixels. And the other option you have is the scene. So you can see that there's vignetting option right over here. So if I were to increase this out, you can see that you get vignette. That is, you get like dark shadows over around in the corner. That is what vignette is. So you can increase this out to make it darker. If you were to like drag it backward, you can see that it becomes whiter right over here. So you got a white vignette right over here, or a dark vignette right over here, as you can see. So usually to draw out attention, you make the edges a bit dark, just like this. So that is something that can be done. So that's vignetting. Then you have fringe right over here. So fringe is more like an effect rather than a necessity, you can see right over here. So you want to give something like an effect to your picture, as if there's a color printing error, then you can have a fringe right over there. I'm just going to leave that out to zero because I don't want any of the fringe. So if your picture is hazy, then you can actually dehaze it out, as you can see right over here. So as you can increase this out, you can see that the reflection and everything else tries its best to remove that out, just like that. As you can see that there's reflection on these buildings right here, you can dehaze it out a bit, and you can see that it tries to bring out the reflection right over here to make the picture much more clear. So I don't want to go all the way out right over here, but just a bit like that to draw out the details. Then you have bloom right over here. So bloom really is just like a brightness, but it is more like a glow, as you can see right over here. So as you want to make the picture look a bit dreamy and so forth, you can actually make it bloom a bit, as you can see right over here. So I'm just going to bring up the bloom just a bit right over here. Then you have glamour right over here. So if you were to increase that out, you can see that it is much more dreamy in look. So you want to give more like a glamour look, you have a model shoot and so forth, you can include the glamour out a bit right over here, as you can see. So let me just decrease that in size. Then you have posterize right over here. So it makes your picture look like a poster, as you can see. So one is truly like a poster. So as you go forward, you can see that it is less like a poster right over here. Zero is the effect is not applied, but you can see right over here, you can make it look more like a poster or bring it down in size, as you can see right over here. Then there's pixelate as an option right over here. So if I were to increase the pixelation, you can see that it gets pixelated. It looks like a low resolution image right over here, just like that. So depending on how much you want to pixelate, you can choose this out as well. So I don't want to work around with that. And then finally, we have the mosaic. That means like it is like pixelate, but it is filled with little pixel triangles, as you can see right here, which looks a bit more artistic in comparison, as you can see. And these are the filters that you can apply in Pixlr X. So over here, we applied some filter over here as well. So what we can do is we can compare before and after. So let me just go around here on to the beginning right over here, just like this. So let's go to open out. So this is what we started with, and this is what we ended out with, as you can see. So we can see a bit of before and after right there. And that is how you can utilize filters inside of Pixlr X. So hope you guys learned something as always. And as always, please like, comment, share, and subscribe.